Then this brings us to JKK implementation. And by that, we wanted to make sure that the team leaders were the main owners and responsible parties for all processes. Team leaders were supposed to check and audit the Pokayoke or error proofing devices on all machines. We had Pokayoke devices on every machine to ensure that bad parts were not even assembled, let alone passed on. So what if the Pokayoke device wouldn't work and you would start your shift thinking that they are functional, but nevertheless they were not working at all? In the beginning of every shift, a dummy door panel was used to warm up the machine, especially on cold days, and that will ensure that all parts of the machines were ready for mass production, something that we didn't used to do, and we didn't know why in the beginning of every shift we had more problems. We came up with this dummy door panel and the warm-up process. We had to do it 3 to 4 minutes only with the dummy door. We wouldn't throw away any part because the door was dummy and scrap anyway, but we would spend the first 3 to 4 minutes of every shift beginning to ensure that all machines were up to the par. And another thing to check the Pokayoke device was use of misassembled part. We would put parts with missing or misassembled components to see whether or not the Pokayoke would catch it. And if Pokayoke would catch, then we would conclude that the error-proofing device was doing its job. Otherwise, we would have to get the maintenance team members to look at it. The team members were asked to record all the machine processes on an hourly basis. Now, if the team members are the owners of the process and they should be held accountable for the quality, then there are responsibilities that goes with it. And one of the things was for the team members, not for the maintenance, to record all the machine processes on an hourly basis. It is something that is very quick and simple, but quite important and worthwhile. Then the maintenance team members would analyze the numbers and adjust the machines if necessary. If maintenance team members would come in and find out that machines were not functioning correctly or the process was out of control, then at that point they would adjust the machine if necessary. And then the layered audits by different people, by the team leader, by the group leader, by QC inspector, by maintenance team member, would ensure the correctness and continuation of the process checks. And the last item I have over here for JKK is called Red Rabbit. And Red Rabbit concept is that you would intentionally mark a part, a defective part, and introduce it, and you mix it with the rest of the parts, and you would wait at the end of the line for that part to arrive, and since it's already marked, you would know it as a manager of the line or as a QC manager or QC supervisor, but the team members on the line don't know it. So you see how they would treat that part. Would they catch the defect? Would they find out that part was defective? Or would they pack it and ready to be shipped to the customer? So based on that red rabbit, you keep everybody on their toes, ready and alert for defects of any sort. And red rabbits, if not implemented carefully, can do some damage as well, meaning that red rabbit can end up at the customer site if not dealt with correctly. That's one sheet for the process of ultrasonic welding machine, which was recorded by team members on an hourly basis. As you see, it's a very simple form, but the main thing is team members are doing it, not the technician, not the supervisors, not the engineers. They do it on an hourly basis by the regular team members on the assembly line. And then the entire thing will be on the dashboard management, visible and visual to all the people who are involved within the assembly for everybody to see. And by everybody, I do include the guests and visitors that we had to the plant. And of course, one philosophy is that you should never air your dirty laundry. And the other philosophy is that, well, why do you have dirty laundry to start with? Why don't you fix it so you are not afraid of airing what's going on in your plant? And dashboard management will allow you to see the KPIs regularly to know the status of your operational process. So there will not be any embarrassing things for the visitor and guests to see, and also it will be very informative for the managers and supervisors and the team members on the floor to see how they are doing.